Someone like Stephen comes in the door, he looks very timid, but he's got a big personality for a little guy. 10 minutes, please. If you can take the details down on the four zeros.
For this patient. Yeah, from A to B to x-rays, CTs and back to the wards.
He works hard, if you give him a chance, then he's going to prove himself. He's very individual.
Most disabled people are not working, and particularly those with learning disabilities. And that's a great shame.
For many of the young people, getting in touch with Action on Disability is that gateway that they've been looking for.
We have these work placement schemes running in partnership with big business here at GlaxoSmithKline, with St George's Hospital, with Sodexo. They're getting an opportunity to see, in particular, people with learning disabilities, what they can really achieve.
So I land up on this reception desk here in January and worked hard, and here I am today.
Ian, he fit right in from the beginning, and we obviously saw the potential very quickly.
Yep. Thanks. Thanks, bye. Well, sometimes I may need to book a room for someone, or kick them out sometimes.
Can you say ask them to leave, not kick them out?
Ask them to leave.
We take great care in placing them where we think it's suitable and where we think they're a good match. For example, we have Natasha working in the restaurant. She's very determined and works really hard.
You help people if they need any help. I like it.
It gives them a future. It gives them hope. It gives them something to aim for, as anybody else would want. You know, you want a career. You want to look forward, give you future plans. This is what it does.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Working in a mayor, you get to see lots of people and see how it runs behind the scenes. Just signed for an incoming delivery, and these will now get sorted with find out the person's location within GSK and deliver it to their desk.
Before I started, I went to college and I had a letter to come here, and I was very proud and I got in. The best thing is working independently.
Ordinarily, if this scheme hadn't been working, you'd have chaps like these being almost marginalised in society, but now it gives them a real opportunity to be a part of society rather than just sitting at home having the telly on and nobody giving them an opportunity.
The departments, if I'm honest with you, were kind of reluctant to take it on because they were unsure and had never worked with people with learning difficulties. Within about 3 or 4 days, they had embraced it quite passionately and actually realised what a benefit it was to them. And that was by just understanding that everybody's different.
A sensible thing to do, I think, would be to give somebody with a learning disability a trial to see how they get on. And I don't think a lot of employers realise that within equalities legislation, they are allowed to do that.
When I'm here at GSK, it still feels like a bit of a dream. My interest in fitness is kind of, I'm very conscious about my health. Whenever they ask me to do something, I just make sure that I try and do it to the best of my ability. Yeah, members of the gym, I do talk to them. What are you training today?
Did a bit of running, so cardio.
Trying to have confidence in my ability. Trying to keep constant eye contact with people when I'm speaking to them. Then I also do some bookings, just booking people in to do some classes in the studio.
So are you okay to get on with those two?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah, more than happy, yeah.
Thank you. We've had this set up before, with Dejon, along with all the other guys, we've seen him go through quite a big change. Coming quite timid, very unsure of themselves, skills on the computer or talking to people. It's quite nice to see them develop and grow into that particular role and as they change and adapt.
Yeah, I wear this black Aspire top. It makes me feel even more part of the team than I was when I first started here. So this project's kind of helping me getting a job into paid employment. That's what I'm trying to gradually build up to. It's been a very, very positive experience so far.
I think employers always think that there's going to be a cost, that there's going to be a lot of time, and it's going to be very complex in hiring somebody with a disability. But the beauty of having a job coach means that you won't have that worry. You'll be able to recruit them immediately with somebody to help them and support them, one-to-one, structured coaching all the way.
We're not talking about your traditional, necessarily your traditional entry-level jobs. There's no limits to what people can do. We've got young people with learning disabilities doing very complex work.
I went to Kensington and Chelsea College, and then I was unemployed for 2 years, and then I came across this program, which will help me find a job for the future. Ever since I've been here, well, I kind of improved on Excel. Well, I'm doing a survey with like people's IDs. It's a really good experience, actually. It's proving people with learning disabilities can work.
What we need is for employers to take on individuals' disabilities for a work trial, for something that's a bit longer than just an interview, because then you can gain the trust of the individual, they can understand a little bit more about the job and spend longer getting to know what there is to do.
I would say to other departments that they should give it a go, because very quickly they will see the commitment that these young guys will give to the department. Ian learned to use the systems very quickly as well, so when a vacancy came out, he was the strongest candidate for the position.
We're now seeing a strong pipeline of our recruits being snapped up by other businesses, because they can see people with learning disabilities doing complex work and being as productive as anybody else.